MSI on oma tootevaliku väga konkreetselt kaheks löönud. Üks osa on suunatud mänguritele ja teine on siis sisuloojatele. Neil on kõigil väga erinev disain ja väga erinev lähenemine, mis ma arvan, et võiks MSI-l ka tagada päris suur korraliku edu. Lisaks riistvara tootmisele on nad järjest enam hakkanud tähelepanu pöörama ka tarkvara arendamisele. Ja no sellele me näeme väga huvitavaid lahendusi, kuidas mängu kogemus ja mängu riistvara omavahel koos reageerima hakkavad.
Selle üheks näiteks on koostus Ubisoftiga arendatud tarkvara Nanoleaf valguslahendusele, mis hakkab reageerima mängus toimuvale, toetades seda vastavat värvi valgusega. Või miks mitte võimalus mängida arvutil 12 mobiilimängu korraga. Sisuloojatele on ka loomulikult oma emaplaadid, mis võrreldes mänguritele suunatud toodetega omavad tunduvalt rohkem USB-pesasid. Mänguritele suunatud riistvaraga oleme ka jõudnud sinna maale, et uueks turunissiks on tooted, kus pole mitte ühtegi leedi.
Today we'll be talking about the X57 Unify. This is our all new motherboard for the second gen Ryzen chipset for the X570. What's new about this board is that it doesn't have the RGB, you know, like any of our other motherboards. So this will be the first pure, you know, black PCB design. And with the extended heatsink, and also a Frozer design, nor a Southbridge.
So this is our Optix MAG342 CQR. So it is our first 1000R curvature gaming monitor. And you can see, the lower the number of the rating, the higher the curve. But we did a lot of research recently, which proves that 1000R is the best viewing angle for your eyeball at a certain distance from the computer. So although it might look like a very heavy curvature when you sit in front of it, it's the most comfortable and the most pleasant to the eye. Now this one is a 2K 32-inch panel, a VA panel, which is G-Sync compatible, and it is a 21:9 aspect ratio with a 144Hz refresh rate and 1 millisecond response time. Now, this one might look a little bit different from our normal Optix monitors. We're kind of trying to follow the prestige design and trying to make it a little bit more in tune to maybe the gamer and the creator as well. So this is our Prestige Series monitor, which is our content creator monitor. It's titled the Prestige PS341WU. It is a 34-inch flat nano IPS panel that's running at a 5K resolution. So we were like, hey, you think you want 4K? Well, we'll give you an extra buffer space to work to put, you know, whatever you would need in the editing programs.
Läpakad saavad aga 99,9 watt-tunnised akud. Miks just see number? Sest see on maksimum suurus, mida lubatakse lennukisse kaasa võtta.
So that is the biggest battery that you can put onto a plane. So there's a lot of people that ask, like, why don't we just do like 100? But 99.9 is the, it fits the regulation standards. So this is our G66 Raider. This is also our newest flagship lineup. A really cool thing about this is, as everyone know, we have the GT76, which is like a very big button of this, but it has the same concept. So the whole thing is like a shrunk down GT76 with all the power, all the performance, and it also has this very sporty look to it. This also does have the one finger handle, so you could just lift it up with, like this, with ease. And as you can see right here, we have a whole light bar, our panoramic Alora lights. Basically, this will actually sync up with your keyboard to have the whole RGB synced up. And as you play games, it actually can simulate like real-time gaming experience. And another cool thing about this, it actually has 16.7 million different colors in it.
Mis oleks aga mänguri arvuti ilma kiirekraanita?
This will also come with the 300Hz refresh rate as an option as well. And it also does have the newest Dino Audio in here. So the sound will actually bounce from the side and also to the bottom. So.
Üheks huvitavamaks uuenduseks oli ka sülearvuti, mis on varustatud 3D ekraaniga, mille vaatamiseks pole prille vaja. Lisaks harjumuspärasele klaviatuurile ja hiirele oli sellel ka käe jälgimisseade, mis võimaldas ekraanil ulmefilmile omaselt objekte liigutada. Antud tehnoloogia väljaarendajatega suheldes mainisid nad, et paari aasta pärast loodavad nad jõuda staadiumisse, kus üle arvutil ei ole klaviatuuri vaja. Võt see oleks lahe.
Here we're trying to incorporate everyone's like their personality into the laptop, so that's why we're coming out with the rose pink, and we also already have it in the market, the pure white and also the carbon gray at the very end. But also we're also coming up with the burgundy color as well. Cooperated with Coley Wirtz, a concept artist from a lot of well-known movies, so like Star Wars, Captain America, Iron Man. We have him design a model with a very spaceship-like features to it. So if you see it on the sides, this is actually laser etchings, so you can actually feel the engravings of the texture. And it will also have all the same features as we do for the G66, but this is just a very limited amount that's going to be coming out soon. Also, when you do plug it on, right here on the edge, it'll actually shine a red light. This is the world's first mini LED laptop for content creation. Basically, Mini LED has 240 different zones. Each of the zones will actually help dim the lights or the darkness to make it really contrast with similar to what OLED has, but without the screen burning. And it also has an HDR of over 1,000 nits. The color accuracy on this display is actually approved by DCI P3, which is DCI P3 100%. In contrast, OLED probably roughly has about 80 to 90%. You can tell the brightness of the color and all the textures that's on the outside. So even in a really dark environment, you can see the little textures that's going on.